Hello, my name is Jim Langridge from Waters, and today I'm going to talk to you about the performance investigation of a novel integrated microfluidics platform for high throughput LC-MSMS MRM disease marker verification. As an overview of what I'm going to talk to you about, I'm going to talk about the IonKey MS system and how we've evaluated this for peptide analysis. This platform exhibits excellent robustness, reproducibility, throughput and sensitivity. And sensitivity limit of detection in the low attomole level on column. As an introduction, why are we doing this? The key part of biomarker discovery and validation is the ability to translate markers to a clinically relevant test. Validation is challenged by the requirement of large sample numbers with high throughput, sensitivity, robustness, accuracy, and precision. MRM has been used for protein biomarker verification using low flow LC-MSMS, but low flow LC systems usually don't offer the required level of performance in terms of accuracy and reproducibility that are required for the assay. So in this case, we're going to talk through the application of the unique IonKey MS system for peptide verification. The IonKey device is shown on the top here, attached to the mass spectrometer. The high temperature co-fired ceramic tile, or the IonKey, as is shown in the middle here, simply fits into the front of the mass spectrometer, where this handle is turned and all of the pressure and voltage connections are applied to the device. The device itself contains all of the components to perform chromatographic separation at the micro scale, including the analytical column, which in this case was 150 microns by 10 centimeters, and also the electrospray emitter, which is shown on the end here and is shown below here in more detail. This is a stainless steel emitter which has a 35 micron internal diameter. So the samples that we're going to use to test the IonKey system are shown in table one. These samples consist of a range of peptides which are produced from the digestion of the proteins which are listed in the table. As well as these native peptides, we have a series of stable isotope labeled analogues which are added to the sample to give the expected ratio as is shown on the right hand side. The amount of material which was applied on column in attomoles is shown in the third column, and this ranges from 3.2 attomoles at the lowest for the lowest peptide here to 4,000 attomoles for the most intense peptide on column. So this covers a typical wide dynamic range which we might see in a protein biomarker verification experiment. Our LC conditions are shown here, where we had a 5 microliter loop at a flow rate of 1.2 microliters per minute through the IonKey device, and we ran a gradient from 0 to 40% B in 45 minutes. Mass spectrometer was a Zevo TQS, high performance tandem quadrupole system, using two different quadrupole resolution settings shown here at 0.4 Daltons or 0.7 Daltons half height. Software processing data as it was acquired was processed with mass links and loaded and analyzed in the Skyline package from the University of Washington. In addition, visualizations were made using the Spotfire decision site software from TIBCO. So let's move on to the results. As you can see in figure two, we're plotting the peak width distributions for all of the peptides in all of the injections which were made onto the IonKey system. And the majority of the eluting peptides had peak widths of less than 5 seconds, as can be seen here. So this highlights the chromatographic performance of the IonKey platform at 1.2 microliters per minute flow rate. Figure three shows a standard deviation versus the average retention time for all of the peptides in all of the injections, and this displays the reproducibility of the IonKey device. Only one peptide, this early eluting peak here, had a standard deviation of greater than 0.03 minutes. Figure 4 shows extracted and overlaid MOM chromatograms for the stable isotope labelled peptides and also for the native peptides which we were detecting, the unlabelled peptides. This shows you and gives you an idea of the chromatographic separation that we were acquiring, and also shows that in fact the stable isotope labelled and native peptides co-elute. Figure 5 is an example of the technical reproducibility of the MOM transitions that we acquired, and these are displayed in Skyline. As you can see, these transitions for both the light peptide and for the heavy peptide, as is shown in figure A and figure B respectively, show very good reproducibility through these given replicates, and coefficients of variation in all cases were under 6%. Figure 6 shows the measurement of a single peptide from carbonic anhydrase. This peptide has the red light analog and the blue heavy analog stable isotope labeled peptide overlaid, and we can see again that they have the same retention time, and in this case they have an area ratio of roughly 10 to 1. If we look at the replicate injections of this peptide across the three injections there, we can again see very good coefficients of variation and very good accuracy and precision on this given peptide. So how about the linear dynamic range which we can achieve? As I mentioned, we injected from 3.2 attomoles to 4,000 attomoles onto the IonKey device. And if we plot the light versus the heavy ratio for each one of the peptides, we can see that we get a linear response across the dynamic range of the peptides which were analyzed in this analysis, irrespective of whether we work at unit quadrupole resolution or whether we tighten the quadrupole resolution and work at elevated quadrupole resolution, as is shown on the right-hand side. Figure 8 shows the typical chromatogram for the peptide from catalase, and here we can assess the chromatographic performance of the device, where we have a peak width at half height of roughly 5 seconds. So in conclusion, the IonKey MS system has been evaluated for peptide quantitation. Quantitative measurements for light and heavy stable isotope labeled peptides showed excellent accuracy and precision, in close agreement with expected values. And finally, the limit of detection has been shown to be under 3.2 attomoles on column. Thank you for your time.